Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Command & Conquer 3 Kane's Wrath, and our featured matchup for the day brings us to the map tournament, Rift. And sliding over to the far left-hand side as the green GDI, we have Granola. And sliding back over to the right-hand side, his opponent for today as the yellow Black Hand, we have Encore. So GDI versus Black Hand here, Granola 17 versus Encore. Tournament Rift, probably one of the most classic matchups we'll ever see. And Encore obviously going to be opening up with a couple of Confessor Cabal squads here. He's got three out on the map at the moment, so drafted two Shredder turrets and also the Hand of Nod being sold off there. Going to be getting him pretty good map coverage, and obviously Black Hand, Black Hand, they do have the ability to get that early scouting advantage, especially against GDI. But it looks like Granola 17 opting not to go for any other scouts aside from just this one, which I believe was actually, that may have actually just been from the sold off barracks. Was that in fact from just the barracks? Yeah, I don't see any additional scouts out on the map, so Granola 17 not investing at all in some early rifleman squads and is going to instead probably going to follow up with a pitbull here. Yeah, exactly what I thought he was going to do. A little bit risky because if that pitbull gets picked off early on, he could be very, very much in the dark. Right now, he's definitely in the dark. Going to be seeing that Confessor Cabal squad there. Going to be taking quite a bit of damage as he tries to drive away. Will manage to get away without going into heavy damage mode, so that's going to be a good thing. Let's take a look and see. Encore going to be getting good eyes on Granola 17's base. We can see two of those Confessor Cabal squads walking in there. Meanwhile, Encore, he's up to two refineries and a single war factory, so no early rush coming out of him. He did have an opportunity to, as he did have that early scouting advantage and maybe going for a little bit of a fancy base layout here as he's got his two power plants. So actually a third power plant being laid up there very close together and obviously all facing the right direction. So very interesting to see that. Encore going to be going for some style points here. Granola 17 maybe going to be paying tribute to that with the beacons. Yeah, okay, so beacons going to be coming out. I figured that's what that was for. MCV going to be taking a little bit of poke here from Encore. The Pitbull's obviously pretty good at adding just a little bit of damage, but those MCVs are very, very tanky. Meanwhile, Granola 17, he's done a classic GDI thing, getting that garrisonable structure on the far side. Just going to be denying any scouts or at least forcing out some kind of a flame weapon to actually deal with that. So going to be seeing maybe an operation center or something to deal with that, or maybe even bikes later on. Both of these Confessor Cabal squads going to be poking down that one power plant. I don't know that any Shredder turrets, or rather Watchtowers, have actually been queued up to actually deal with this, so it seems like Granola 17 is okay with losing that cash, having to repair that power plant over time. I don't know that that's necessarily worth it. Honestly, you could probably just drop down a Watchtower. Okay, so he has actually done that now. I did miss it just a second ago. He is going to go ahead and kill those guys off. He did have to repair that power plant for quite a long time, and I know his other power plant took a bit of damage there, so he could have potentially been keeping that money under his own control. The MCV here, or rather construction yard from Encore, actually down to about 0.5% HP, or rather half of its HP, 50% in other words. That's what I was actually looking for. And that Pitbull will get away. It does spot that there is a harvester here at the Blue Tiberium. Encore, it looks like there was a bit of a miss micro. Pitbull actually trying to engage back into the Scorpion tank. That must have been a miss rally there for Granola 17. He will be losing that Pitbull for that mistake. A little bit unfortunate. We do see Encore going to be sending his Harvester down with some Scorpion tank coverage there. That's a very safe thing to do. Granola 17 doesn't seem to be too fussed about it. He seems to be very, very comfortable ecoing here, realizing that he did get the Pitbull scout into the base of Encore and seeing that he is just ecoing here at the moment for the time being. And that's exactly what's going on. We do have an operation center down before a second war factory or anything else. Typically, you will see that first expansion drop down a refinery, and then the builds usually differ from there. As we can see, Granola 17, he has opted to go for that second war factory before any additional tech or another refinery for that matter. So it is kind of interesting to see that transition away as far as the meta is concerned. As far as what builds you can go with. So, Operation Center down, that lends me to believe that there's going to be a Flame Tank out on the map. There's one there. Let's see if there's anything else out on the map. We do have a Confessor Cabal squad up in the top of the map, so he knows this path hasn't been scouted. Likewise, Encore does have a scout in the middle of the map as well, so he feels pretty comfortable that this Flame Tank is going to get in unscouted. Meanwhile, Granola 17 going to be flexing his muscle here in the middle of the map, going to be getting a crush on the Confessor Cabal squad here that's just chilling out by the Blue Tiberium. So it looks like Encore actually had his scouts all the way across the map, maybe just trying to find an opportunity for this Flame Tank to find a clear pathway here. And it looks like it will get a free opportunity to actually poke in and do some damage. Granola 17, he does have a Pitbull or two out at the moment, so he does have potential to actually stop this. Radar jamming missile comes in, and where is that Flame Tank? Okay, so the Flame Tank's going to be coming in from the north, maybe just trying to throw Granola 17 for a loop here, get him looking around the map, seeing what's going on. But that is a little bit scary, to say the least. Harvester on the rally to the Blue Tiberium there will get picked off by the Predator Tank Army here coming out from Encore. In the meanwhile, we do have the Flame Tank actually rolling in. Does manage to drop down the refinery, or manage to force the sell-off there. And we do actually have the Temple of Nod, the decoy Temple of Nod, being dropped down. Power plant does go down, but the Flame Tank will go down after that. So he got himself at least the force of sell-off of the refinery and a power plant kill. So not the worst thing in the world, but honestly, that Flame Tank needed to do a bit more damage, I think, as we do see that Predator Tank Army going to be rolling through the middle of the map. So this is going to be scary for Encore. He needs to start pumping out infantry, and he needs to start pumping it out now. It's actually a bit behind here. Not quite sure what he's been up to in the meantime. He does have tier four click plant, as it's referred to nowadays, and we will be seeing that out on the map. I did hear an obelisk firing off here, so two obelisks here on the front lines, as we do have that dual MCV out. We did see that just a second ago from Encore, and it's going to be three obelisks here down to deal with the Predator Tank Army, and the Predator Tanks are absolutely being annihilated here. A fourth obelisk comes down, just adding insult to injury, and all of these Predator Tanks have gone down. They've managed to claim one power plant kill for about a dozen or so Predator Tanks, and that's definitely not worth. And we do have APM APCs as well as Predator Tanks going to be rolling through the middle of the map. This is a pretty scary looking force that's actually just streaming across the map. So as we can see, Granola 17, he's really heavily invested in this. And it looks like Encore, he does have the Temple of Nod. Okay, so he does still have that decoy Temple of Nod in the base of Granola 17. That's still just kind of chilling out there. I did see the timer up there in the top left and just wanted to be safe. Anyways, we do have Obelisk being dropped here behind the second MCV to try to keep this alive, and Obelisk actually being micro to kill off that APC. Needs to be focusing down the Predator Tanks in this situation. Those are definitely the high priority targets, and a decent number of these guys get picked off. It looks like the Charged Particle Beam upgrade has been purchased by Encore as well, so that is on the cards for them. More and more obelisk drops coming down. We do see Shredder turrets coming down as well. So actually, is that three MCVs? Wow, that's triple MCV out for Encore. So he has got a lot of base defense dropping coming in the near future. I did not see that third MCV come out. But we will be seeing the Tier 1 army here from Granola 17 trying desperately to move around the map and to kill stuff off. If he trades a Predator tank for an obelisk, I think that's probably worth in that situation. And if he can start picking off some power plants, it starts making this attack a little bit more worthwhile. And obviously, if you can get him into low power state, that would be good. But I think Encore honestly has too much economy and too much, obviously, in the way of build queues. So he can just rebuild those power plants so, so fast. That one MCV still down at about half HP. Two obelisks still chilling out here. Those could potentially be sold off. Don't really need to be held on to at this point. And honestly, that's just kind of money down the drain for Encore at this point. And we do have power plants getting picked off here, and it looks like it may be a low power state here for Encore. No, he is still powered up. Just wanted to check in on those obelisks, see if they do have power. More obelisks being dropped, but the refinery is going to go down there. So Granola 17 picking off what he came there to kill, and he does manage to clean up that refinery. So just going to be forcing Encore to actually rebuild that. I think we did hear another... Thought for a second that we did hear another one of those radar jamming missiles, but I'm not quite sure if there was anything around the map. Doesn't look like either player has actually gone for these southern Tiberium spikes, and that's actually kind of a mistake in my opinion. Either one of these guys could potentially have gone for those Tiberium spikes, but I guess they're so heavily invested in either trying to base push here or rather have the multi-MCV strat. Oh, we do have Tib Vane coming off. It's going to get a lot of those Predator tanks as well. As you can see, as they get off of the Tiberium field, they still start taking damage. And a lot of them do go down. Some of them will get away with just a tiny bit of HP. But meanwhile, we do have actually... Whoa, what in the world? Slingshots? That must have been a mistake. Or it's being used as a method to deal with some infantry spam. Very odd to see... very, very odd to see those indeed. I'm thinking that must have been a mistake. I can't imagine that was intended. I mean, yes, they are good at crushing infantry, but Slingshots definitely not going to be a worthwhile investment here for Granola 17 against Black Hand. Black Hand do not have the ability to actually produce any aircraft. Did hear a Tib Catalyst missile, I thought, and it looks like maybe it did come down here and hit one of the refineries. No, maybe not. I'm honestly not sure where that hit. Okay, there it is. That was odd. Maybe I just imagined it before. But we do have the Juggernauts actually managing to take down the MCV. So the second MCV, or third MCV rather, does go down. There are still two MCVs out on the map here for Encore, so he does still have that multi-MCV strat going for him. Doesn't actually have any base defenses queued, And now that there are a decent number of Juggernauts out on the map, I don't think he's going to want to continue to invest into that strategy. Slingshot still out on the map, still running around, probably getting some good scouting information. It is actually a decent scouting unit because it's so fast and it has a decent amount of vision radius. So not the worst. I guess not the worst unit in the world as long as you're not building like a mass of them against somebody that's just spamming out base defenses. Obviously, it's not going to be worthwhile. And I honestly want to believe that that was a mistake, but it's they're a decent method of crushing infantry, which obviously Black Hand are quite famous for. So we'll have to see. Encore, he's in a tough position, though. He does not really have a standing army to speak of. Grenoble 17's managed to push him off of that middle Tiberian field, and he's getting free time to harvest on this field. He did get clicked here, so we did see a refinery go down. I'm not sure if he got a harvester as well, but looks like there is still a Tier 1 army being produced here for Grenoble 17. Doesn't look like he's invested too much more into tech. We don't actually see Marv out on the field for him yet. We do have more and more of those Juggernauts. A lot of Juggernauts out on the map. Wow, that's actually a significant amount of Juggernauts. And it looks like we do have Tibcorp bikes rolling around here for Encore, maybe looking to pick up some harvester kills, potentially come in and catch out any units that are in just small numbers. Those bikes very, very good at just adding some damage here. They should be able to take out that Pitbull, but going to be trading one Pitbull for one bike. Definitely still going to be worthwhile trade there for Encore. That Juggernaut army, though, is in incredible numbers, and it's probably going to have to be dealt with via EMP. I can't imagine that there's really any other way of dealing with it. Obviously, base defense is not going to be any type of way of dealing with those Juggernauts because they are just going to outrange them all day long. And we do have a couple of Pitbulls here down at the original expansion here from Grenoble 17. Just going to be kind of holding the line, making sure that those harvesters are safe. There are a lot of harvesters down there, though, for very little Tiberium left, and they should probably be rallied up to this field. There's still quite a bit of Tiberium to be harvested off of this field. Meanwhile, the clock's ticking, I think, here on Encore. He really needs to make something happen. Bikes come in. They do survive a volley from those Juggernauts, and now they are forcing the Juggernauts to fall back. Lots and lots of Juggernauts getting picked off. Two go down straight away, and now the rest of the Juggernauts are caught completely out of position. Grenoble 17 losing about a dozen Juggernauts here. I may be exaggerating here, but a bit, but there's at least a half a dozen Husks sitting there on the field. Looks like a Tiberian Vapor Bomb going to be coming in, claiming a couple more of those low Juggernauts, at least one for certain. And now the remainder of these Husks are being cleaned up. So just the Tier 1 army left here for Grenoble 17, plus a handful of Juggernauts. And by that, I do mean two. And he does have an airfield down, so could potentially be seeing Firehawks or some kind of Hammerhead or Orca transition. Honestly, all three units I think would be good in this situation. Hammerheads in particular, just due to the fact that there's likely going to be some kind of an infantry transition here coming out from Encore in the near future. But he does need to be careful. Obviously, Tibcorp bikes, very, very scary. And, Bike Buggy is very, very good on this map. So it is a scary thing to deal with. We'll have to see. Encore still needs to trade really, really effectively. He did a great job of cleaning up that Juggernaut army, which was potentially going to be a game ender for him. He does manage to keep himself alive by taking that army out. Grenoble 17, the question is, will he make the mistake of leaving those guys undefended once again? Pitbull's going to be rallying down to the south. Not sure if they caught wind of the Bike Buggy. And by Bike Buggy, I do mean, in fact, it's just bikes, and it's going to be Tibcorp bikes versus Pitbulls here. And the Tibcorp bikes definitely have more damage output, so over time, they definitely will win out in this fight. Decoy Army comes down as well, just going to make it that much more difficult to actually target the real bikes, and the remainder of these bikes will survive. Pitbull's going to be streaming in one by one, but definitely not how you want to be dealing with these bikes, especially Tibcorp bikes. They're going to be taking these Pitbulls out one by one very, very quickly, and we can see they're all going to be going down. And just trading very, very effectively there for Encore. Still nobody going for these bottom Tib spikes. Looks like Encore has managed to grab a garrison here, so he does have complete control over that bottom area for the time being. And did I hear another Tiberium Catalyst missile? Thought I did. I don't know. Am I imagining it once again? I think I am. Yeah, I think I honestly am. But anyways, we do have bikes going to be just continuing to come in and poke a little bit of damage here. And even two bikes are a threat, as they do have that Tib core. And as you can see, they did manage to take down that Pitbull very quickly. Probably going to be poking a little bit more damage onto these harvesters before they do both go down. And we do see them burn down into the ground there. And we do have a couple of Juggernauts out, just three Juggernauts and a decent number of Predator tanks out on the map for Grenoble 17. Does not seem to be sure of himself to actually move out and put some pressure here on Encore. We do have a, it looks like a beacon, which is going to be some kind of an Orca strike, I would imagine, coming in to hit that MCV. Maybe just trying to get some vision over here, see what is going on. in the way of defenses here and other just unit compositions, maybe trying to scout out to see if there's any infantry transition here. Pretty decent trading here coming in from Granola 17, managing to clean up a lot of those bikes, and he should get himself a harvester kill here at the Blue Tiberian Field, which will definitely be a good pickup. Keeping that out of the hands of Encore is just going to be starving him out even more. But he needs to be careful not to be trading SOCAS ineffectively, because that's what's allowing Encore to stay in this game. He does still have his Tiberium chemical plant, which I can't imagine that he has money to actually fund. There is a flame tank out on the map as well. I did miss that a second ago. Those obelisks, both of those obelisks, are still there from that original fight. But we do have Pitbulls going to be continuing to chase away these harvesters, but they are going to be straying into the obelisks here, and those all of the Pitbulls will be going down. So again, not trading very effectively here, as we do see that final Pitbull go down. We do have a decent-sized army here moving out for Granola 17. It is just going to be Predator tanks and a couple of Juggernauts. Juggernauts are pretty far behind, so they need to start catching up here. Maybe just trying to bait out the obelisk drops here from Encore. But really, there's no anti-infantry defense here for Granola 17. He's pulling those Predator tanks very far back. They honestly need to be a lot further forward. Maybe try to bait the bikes into attacking. But honestly, those Juggernauts, they're getting free shots right now, as we do not see the bikes actually rallying up to deal with them. Whoa, stealth base down here in the bottom left for Encore. He's managed to send his MCV all the way down to the bottom. Is he going to get the Reclamator Hub? Flame Tank's made its way all the way down around to the bottom side. It will get the Reclamator Hub, but the Marv. No, it's not a Marv. It's not a Marv. It's a Predator Tank. Where's the Marv? Second Flame Tank comes in, does manage to take down the Reclamator Hub, and I don't think there's actually a Marv out on the field. Is there a Marv out on the field? Did I completely miss it? No, there is no Marv out on the field, so the Reclamator Hub goes down. And Granola 17 missing an opportunity there. Not quite sure why he put that on the map if he was not going to build his Marv. That's very, very unfortunate indeed. Flame Tank doing a lot of work here for Encore on the backside of things. We do have a bit of a base trade situation coming out here, as we do have Granola 17 just sweeping through this base completely undefended. But the problem is, this base trade is not going to work out well for him, as he has to contend with a stealth base here down in the bottom left. And by stealth, I just mean that it's a sneaky base down there in the bottom corner of the map. We do have Tipcore bikes continuing to clean up harvesters around the map. There are a couple of Predator tanks out. That will keep those guys at bay. But the Predator tank's now going to be coming in and getting some crushes here. No, it looks like they are going to fall back, as the Juggernauts are going to clean up these two remaining obelisks. And Encore, he's still in this game. He does have his build here down in the bottom left. He's going to be spamming out infantry. A very safe thing to do here, especially late in game for Black Hand. It's a very cost-effective method of getting some units out on the field and have yourself a standing army pretty quickly. But the remainder of his base is being ravaged. There is still a little bit of infrastructure here, and he will get away with another little bit of Tiberium here in the top right. And Granola 17 will need to go up there and clean that stuff up in the very near future. But honestly, Encore, he's in a tough position. He's managed to sweep through the left side of the map pretty well, but was not able to continue on with that flame tank, as there were a couple of Predator tanks out to try to deal with this. It looks like Granola 17 sending down a few rifleman squads just to try to test the defenses here of Encore and see what he's got left. And he is going to run into this infantry army. Encore playing this smart. I've got these guys backwards now because they're on the opposite ends of the map. And we will be seeing the rifleman squads getting picked off there by the supercharge, or rather the charge particle beams on those Confessing of All squads. But we do have a decent number of harvesters which are managing to rally from across the map. Not sure what these guys are doing, just kind of chilling out. Don't seem to be really gathering any Tiberium from around the map. It looks like, in the meantime, Encore has managed to grab himself both of the Southern Tiberium spikes, realizing that that was a missed opportunity earlier in the game. He does manage to take out the Tiberium spike of Granola 17 in the meantime. And it looks like Granola 17 repaid the favor here, as we do see that Tiberium spike is long gone. So it looks like those guys were actually taken out quite a long time ago. Do you have a decent-sized infantry army? The Rifleman Squad will manage to sneak past, so he should get a decent scout here. He should be able to get into the base of Encore and see exactly what is going on. He's actually got a decent amount of information here. I think he can actually see the Hand of Nod. Can definitely see the War Factory here. But now we do have Shredder turrets coming down from Encore. We're going to be trying to keep eyes on what's going on here. APC is going to be rolling through the middle of the map, but they are definitely outnumbered here. Not sure what the Predator tanks are doing. They need to be getting into range, even if they're just tanking this frontline force. Honestly, that would be better than what they're doing right now. Sniper teams on the front lines here as well. Going to be sitting there behind the APC. He's going to be picking off the remainder of this infantry. Encore, he is still in this game, though. We do have bikes rolling through the backside of the base of Granola 17. Going to be looking to go Harvester hunting at this point. And honestly, Harvester is going to be a great pickup here. If he can just continue to trade cost effectively here, he could potentially keep himself in this game. Granola 17, though, he's on the warpath. He's got a decent-sized Predator tank army. He's going to be sweeping through the remainder of this base, and it looks like he should be coming out on top. Not quite sure what Encore has left. It looks like he does still have a decent amount of forces around the map, but it's looking like this may be it. MCV is still trying to get away, but honestly, this is not looking too good for Encore. MCV actually not going to get focused down. Granola 70. Okay, so he does see it. I was worried there for a second that he did not actually see it, but now the MCV will go down, and that will likely signal the defeat here from Encore. No, he's actually dropped two hands of Nod back at his refinery here. He did still have some build radius. The question is, does he have any money? And let's take a quick peek and see what he's got. He does still have 5K, so he can actually focus, or rather, he can actually pump out a decent amount of rocket squads. So Encore is not out of this game just yet. Surprisingly enough, has managed to keep this base alive in the top right and has been managing to drop all of his additional infrastructure up there. There are still a decent number of sniper teams out on the map, and those were called in from a support power there. Juggernauts have actually been built back up to a decent-sized force as well. We have, as we can see, we have those six Juggernauts out on the map. Looks like there are just some lone members of these Confessor Cabal squads left alive here for Encore. But Encore, he's just continuing to spam out more infantry here in the top right corner. It looks like there's a few bikes left as well, just going to be trailing around from some earlier hit and runs. But Granola 17's completely sold up his base at the middle of the map. Oh man, I don't know about the choice to sell up this base. That was a mistake. Okay, so now he's going to be rolling through the middle of the map with his MCV. He's going to try to hunt down Encore and snuff him out and just bring his MCV along for the ride. I don't know about the choice to bring this along. Maybe he's just worried about engineers coming along and grabbing his MCV while he's not paying attention. That would be pretty devastating, but there are a couple of flame tanks rolling around. That's actually a heroic flame tank. That flame tank is elite as well, so very, very scary flame tanks to say the least. But Harvester's all going to be returning from long distance harvesting with full loads of Tiberium here. So there is still a chance that Encore is left in this game. And he does have an opportunity here to take out Granola 17. I don't know why Granola 17 has not built any infrastructure here. Just rolling around with that one MCV is a death wish. Especially when he has the superior army size. He can just camp this one out, get up some infrastructure here, knowing that he's managed to take out the last MCV of Encore. And over time, he will definitely win this fight. But he's not actually built anything. He unpacked his MCV for nothing. Why would he do that? There are flame tanks rolling around the backside here. It looks like Encore has not been spotted with those flame tanks, but there are Predator tanks trailing behind the MCV. The MCV is following behind these Juggernauts. Again, very strange tactics here coming out from Granola 17. Not what I would choose to do in this situation, but he seems to be very weary of the flame tanks at this point in time. And honestly, it's maybe not the worst thing in the world, but he's got so many Predator tanks. He can just camp this one out, get up to a decent-sized force, get out some hammerheads or something, get around the map, see what he's up against, maybe even just get out an opportunity to get some radar scans down, and he should be able to do a little bit more work there. Actually, a heroic bike cruising around the map here as well. Gonna manage to take down a Juggernaut here, so that's actually really good, and he can kite out these Juggernauts really, really easily, so this is not the worst thing in the world here for Encore. Encore, he's got two flame tanks coming in from the backside. The question is, will Granola 17 see this coming? Looks like one of those Juggernauts is veteran status. Oh, the Predator tank army comes back in and surrounds the MCV. So Encore still just chilling out with those flame tanks. Doesn't seem to want to engage into that MCV. This is very, very scary. I don't know what Granola 17 is doing. He must not have any money. That's what it is. He doesn't have any money. Oh my god, he doesn't have any money. That's why he hasn't built any infrastructure. He doesn't have the funds. He's pulling back the MCV! He's pulling back the MCV into the flame tanks! It's been spotted! The Predator tanks are coming back to deal with it! It's not going to get there in time! The MCV is taking a lot of damage here, but now all of the Juggernauts, they're trying to focus down the flame tanks and the infantry. Oh my god! The MCV has almost no HP left! He has no money to repair it either. The rocket squads just need to suicide forward, kill the MCV if they can get into range. What is going on in the top right? Just battle markers from stepping on Tiberium. Oh my god, is he going to get the MCV? It's so close to going down. The black kid, the black disciples are going to run forward. Are they the heroes that they need to be? No, they're not. Their sniper teams are still alive. They are going to manage to take down those black disciples. Oh my God, Encore. So close to taking a victory, but not able to take down the MCV. And the MCV is still alive here. It is getting some repairs. He's got a structure queued, but he needs to sell that. He needs to just cancel it and get that MCV repaired. He needs to just bring the MCV along for the ride. The time has long passed to try to get out any engineers or anything. He should have taken the opportunity to grab some engineers into those Tiberium spikes. Maybe that's why he sent it to the blue Tiberium field in the original instance. But anyways, we are going to be seeing the infantry engage into the Juggernauts. They're actually getting an opportunity to come in here. The Juggernauts do have them suppressed, but the Confessor Cabal squads with the charged particle beam upgrades are going to be doing quite a bit of damage. The Juggernauts are taking a lot of damage. Now the sniper teams are coming into range. They are going to be doing a good job of cleaning up, but they are having to kite back. The garrison here actually managing to kill off some of the sniper teams, and Granola 17 is forced to cut and run. His MCV is still getting repaired, but it doesn't have any money. He needs to cancel the structure that he's queuing right now. He doesn't have the money to build it. Just cancel it and get the repairs back online. Oh my God, he's going to lose this game. I can't believe this. He's going to try to he packs up the MCV. He's going to try to run away. It's too late. He can't cut and run now. The Predator tanks come forward. They try to get the crushes off. The sniper teams, they go elite, but they're not going to survive long enough. The MCV will go down, and Dreadnought, aka Granola 17, has been defeated. Oh my God. I don't even know what to say. Encore comes out on top in that game, and that was a bloodbath. Man, I never would have expected that game going the way it did. And that was the cake of the century, I think. Encore coming through in the clutch there with the flame tanks on the backside of things, just catching Granola 17 between a rock and a very hot place, as we did see the flame tanks rolling up through the backside and doing a lot of damage to the MCV. And just the curse of not having any funds to actually build anything was a really bad situation there for Granola 17. Those flame tanks really paying dividends, and honestly just the superior trading there from Encore really coming out on top. And I bet it's it's not going to be translated there in the unit KD ratio, just because obviously he is Black Ant, so the infantry spam kind of makes up for that. But wow, that was a crazy game. I was not expecting that. I didn't have my hopes up too high for this game, but it really delivered. That was a very, very close game. Honestly, it could have gone either way earlier on, and I honestly thought Granola 17 was in a really commanding position when he managed to push Encore off that middle field. But he just wasn't able to capitalize on it, and Encore was able to trade cost-effectively, get those flame tanks ranked up, and allow those guys to sneak around the map. He did a great job with the stealth base down in the bottom left corner to keep himself alive earlier on when he got pushed out by the Tier 1 army, or rather the Predator tanks and Juggernauts pushing through the right-hand side of the map into his original base. So Encore just all over the map in this game, and he just did a great job of kind of outsmarting Granola 17 in this game. So solid game from both of these guys. Very interesting to see. Unfortunately, Granola 17 kind of struggling there at the end, obviously, with low funds, not able to really do too much about it, having to just take his MCV in tow to try to stay alive. But very, very solid game from both of these guys. Fun game to watch, and nice to be back casting some single games here as opposed to just straight-up tournaments all the time. Let's just take a quick glance at the resources because I'm kind of curious. Yeah, Granola 17, I was going to say, he must have been dominating in resources for the majority of that game, and he was. He was way up and over the top of Encore, but you can see it flatlined towards almost the last 10 minutes of the game, as he just didn't have a refinery, didn't have any ability to rebuild it, and Encore was able to get caught back up and just managed to keep Granola 17 at bay for long enough to stay alive. So great game from these guys. Certainly a fun game to watch. Not the most epic, pro-level gameplay, but definitely a fun game nonetheless. So I hope you guys all enjoyed the video here today. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll catch you all next time.